sponsored by Stampede Beer. The plus is hush hush.
Hi, welcome back. Joining us on our couch right now is NBA icon and slam dunk champion Spud Webb. He's going to give us some insight on LeBron's new movie. Hey, Spud.
How's it going, Tommy?
Good to see you, man. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, let's go right to it and check out More Than a Game. When director Christopher Bellman began to follow a high school basketball team for a planned short film, he had no way to know that this scrappy group of inner city kids would eventually become the most hyped sports story in history. Their secret? The future NBA star LeBron James, one of the most dynamic players to ever play the game.
This all started in a little gym with a linoleum floor on Maple Street.
It would have been easy for the filmmaker to focus solely on LeBron, the obvious star and phenomenon who is now one of the most famous men on earth. But the movie wisely gives all the players their due, introducing each player in a natural and organic way and giving each their own story to tell.
Sean wasn't very good. He was big, but he wasn't very good.
One thing that you need to be a champion, eat Wheaties.
Willie had been through so much.
He was just a little bit more mature than the other guys.
I definitely learned a lot from my brother about sacrifice.
That probably was the hardest time in his life. I never thought basketball was going to be...
The real-life drama on display here is enough for 10 basketball movies as these kids' individual stories play out in the national spotlight. Even though we know how the tournament eventually ends, the players' lives are so fascinating and real that new surprises are always just around the corner.
Senior year, it was all five of us, hands on each other's shoulders, none can stand in our way, none's gonna separate us.
These are young kids, and they started blowing teams out.
5-0, 15-0, 20-0.
They couldn't believe we're still winning.
LeBron James is ineligible to play.
So here we go, the high school national championship on the line.
More Than a Game.
This is a once-in-a-lifetime story of personal challenges and ultimate victory, and how the power of a team can pull individuals together to become more than themselves. We are given a rare glimpse into the origin story of an NBA superhero, a lucky break that a filmmaker treats with respect and slam dunks with authority. You know, Spud, it's amazing. This story was more than a documentary to me. It was more like a full-length feature film.
Yeah, it was real life. It was real life stories of a big-time basketball player we know today, and we found out that we all do things that come along and have problems, and we fight through them, and that's where you persevere, and that's why we are here today, because this film brings it out of inspiration to all high school basketball players can relate to this.
Yeah, it's amazing, too, how LeBron treats his friends, his fellow players. He's the greatest player on the courts today, maybe they'll say of all time. And here he is, he gives the respect to his other players on his team today and back in high school.
For me, More Than a Game was, it was a nice inside look to the, you know, to the crescendo of the final product, who LeBron James is, the idea of it all. Just when you hear somebody coming straight out of high school, you think, oh, that's just too easy, you know? I mean, what was he drinking, that milk with the steroids or something? I don't know, because I was busting my rear in high school to get to 6 foot tall, let alone 6'6", and dominating at that level was, I mean, what do you think? I mean, how does that compare to your story?
Well, my story is I just worked hard to get there. I mean, most guys... They have the talent, and what you have with a guy like LeBron that has talent, they have the killer instincts. And most guys that have talent, you say, okay, he has talent. Right. But this guy has killer instincts.
And there's an arrogance usually, right, that comes with that swagger.
Some people call it arrogance. I call it that they're just confidence in themselves. Sure. And that's what you get with LeBron. And it shows that we're lucky to get it that young to see it, because most people think we just put on shorts and go out there and play. Certainly. But they see how this guy fought through. Persevered through everything to make it to the top of his profession.
Oh, yeah.
Now, you were in high school. You played ball. Tell me how it felt when you were in high school. Did you feel that you were going to make it to the NBA? you know, then become, you're never going to dream you're going to become slam dunk champion. But, you know, what are you dreaming? What are you thinking about? What was LeBron thinking about? We heard him in the film, but was that true? What are you saying?
Yeah, I mean, you always have idols that somebody catch your eye and you want to be like. You end up, you can't be like them, but you work hard enough to get where you can stand and play. I watched Dr. J, and I'm pretty sure he's Michael Jordan because he wears number 23. And that's a bold move for a guy to put 23 on, but he actually lives up to it. So it just that you see a guy like that, and he puts it in front of us, and every day we critique everything he does. And until he get a championship, he's not going to be known as the greatest player ever. But Michael still will hold that. But at least we have something to hold on to as an entertainer and as great as he is.
And I really loved it. And I got to tell you, for me, it matches up there with some of these real inspirational films like The Rookie and these other Disney films that and Rocky that you cheer at the end. And so you're really happy and excited. And this movie was motivating, inspiring for me. You know, you're an ex-NBA player, slam dunk champion, icon in the field. Did it inspire you? How did you really feel about this film?
Well, you're always like I said, the high school kids and the inspiration you get, like any guy that's walking around that plays sports, you say, that was me, that was my friend, that's that superhero that we had on our team that we all looked up to, we all wanted to be like, and knew that he was going to be something special. But what he brings out in the film is that he's showing the gradually growth of LeBron James, and we get to see it right in front of eyes.
Which you never get that opportunity. No. Okay, tell me for Spud Webb, how many beers in our beer rating? It's 1 to 6. You got a 6-pack, is as good as it gets. There we go. How do you rate this LeBron movie?
Well, I'm biased and I'm a fan of his, so I'm gonna rate it as high as he can get, 6, because it's inspirational. And all kids need to know and see like movies like that, because I'm gonna give it 6 beers.
6 beers,
because
okay.
It's what we all need to know about people.
Zach, how do you rate this movie?
I won't give it 6 beers, but that's because I'm biased. I'm a football fan. Yeah, but I'll give it 5 beers for each of the basketball players. How about that? They each get a beer.
I think that everybody else out there making documentaries, you're gonna see a change. In the way films are made. It was exciting. I've got to give it, the 6 beer level is as high as it gets, and it's pretty exciting. Can I do 5 beers and a light beer? So we're up there. But it was great for me and a great film to watch. So I'm going to tell everybody at home they should watch that film, LeBron's new movie. And I think he's going to be excited about people to watch that film. So we'll be right back. We want to thank Anthony Spud Webb for joining us on the couch and getting his take on LeBron's new movie.
LeBron James is on track to be the first $1 billion athlete.
Great! He's my favorite football player.